You know, a couple of years ago, a lot of Americans were shouting in the street, had signs, and they were talking about how America had turned into some sort of fascist state. But you see, the American people were so naive that what they probably weren't aware of is that America has been a fascist state for a very long time. You see, fascism is when you marry corporation with government. When those corporations dictate policy to better the corporation, to better the government, because they're both working in unison, hand in hand. And you see, America had become a fascist state in the 30s. Because let me tell you something. In the teens and 20s, they used to promote a thing called marijuana. It was a relaxing sort of tobacco and, you know, why not smoke a little? Happy tobacco. But you see, by 1913, California had outlawed marijuana. By 1930, so many different states in the Union had outlawed marijuana. And in 1937, the United States Congress made hemp illegal. Now, why would they do that? Would they outlaw that because they're so concerned about you and your welfare? Because they don't want you going crazy or getting violent? Oh no. Because it's about the almighty dollar. The almighty dollar. That's right. That's in your own history. You see, in 1937, Congress passed a law that would make hemp illegal. And do you even know why? I'll tell you why. Because there was a gentleman by the name of William Hearst that owned a paper manufacturing company. That's right. There was also another company by the name of DuPont Company that in 1937 patented a process by means of petrochemical, by the use of oil, to make plastics, methane, all kinds of different products. That's right. And if those companies had to compete with hemp, they would have lost at least 80% of their profit. So once again, yeah, the American people lost and industry won. All over again. Yeah. It's sad, but it's true. It's so sad, but it's true. And you see, marijuana, just for the medicinal purposes, would outweigh almost every medication on demand even today. Because you can rarely take a medicine even today without some sort of side effect. What kind of side effect would you have with marijuana? What, you got the munchies maybe? Maybe a little cotton mouth? eyes water up a little bit? Slurred speech, maybe? And all these other different medications made by who? Industry. Oh, yeah. But you see, the United States of America and its government, when they needed to turn a quick buck, what did they turn to? They turned to drugs. You see, during the Iran-Contra affair, the CIA created a drug called crack cocaine. And that drug was introduced into Los Angeles. It was cheap, it was quick, and it was a quick buck. And it was a triple-edged sword. Because as they're selling this crack cocaine in Los Angeles, knowing that it was highly addictive, they would reap the rewards and then turn around and prosecute those who bought it and those who sold it and made money through the judicial system. Oh, Americans are suckers! Oh, Americans are suckers. And this is why you will never defeat the New World Order. We are smarter than you. We are more creative than you. We are faster than you. And we have more money than you. Yep. Absolutely hysterical. You will never, ever be able to compete with the New World Order. We will feed you the medicines that we make. We will give you the aspirins that we decide. Not you. You are our property. That's all there is to it. Hell with fascism! Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. You can't compete with the New World Order. You never could, and you never will. So let me ask you a question. You think I'm blowing smoke?